Hey guys, welcome back to the Cocco channel and to a really different video for my channel. Every once in a while I kind of let you guys in on some personal things that happen in my life, and I try and do that just so you guys know that I'm like honest, and I want to share things like this because it is either A, gonna help me, or B, gonna help somebody out in the universe who is watching YouTube. So I kind of clickbaited you guys with the title, I Quit. So this is like a deep, dark secret that I have had for quite some time, and not a lot of people know this. I could probably count on one hand how many people know this fact about me, is that I am an ex-smoker. I know a lot of you are probably saying, what? Because anytime somebody did find out that I was a smoker, they always told me, you don't look like a smoker, which I don't really know what that means. Like, not every smoker is the little lady from Beetlejuice who has like the lines and the raspy voice, and you know what I mean, like coughs up gross stuff. I mean, maybe in the privacy of their own home, but they don't walk around like that, you know what I mean? Like, I know quite a few smokers that are still smoking. They don't look like, you know what I mean? Like, not everybody looks like a smoker who is a smoker, right? So I remember, it's been about a year now, I want to say, maybe even more than a year, a really great friend of mine, Mary from Glitzy Fritzy, did a tag on quitting smoking, and I just remember thinking to myself, like, someday I'm going to do that tag. Like, I want to be able to. This is something that I've struggled with for a really long time, which in the questions you'll figure out all the details of how long and all that, but I just remember how inspirational Mary was from, you know, for doing this tag, and I just remember thinking, like, someday I'm gonna be able to do that tag, and today is that day. So let's go ahead and get started. There are 11 questions. The number one question is, when did you start smoking and when was your last cigarette? So I started smoking when I was, I think I was about 16. It was the year that I was uprooted from Las Vegas and moved to Arkansas. And I'm not placing the blame on anything, but that's just, I feel like, what a lot of kids did in that town. There wasn't a whole lot to do. And I did fall victim, I feel like, a lot to peer pressure with some things. Some things, like, I absolutely did not do, that a lot of my friends did, but smoking was definitely one of them. Everybody, like, on lunch was outside, you know, smoking, and not like back in the old days where they let you on campus, but we used to sneak off campus and smoke, and after school, you know, everyone caught a ride with each other and we were all smoking. And seriously, I felt like probably about 80% of, maybe even more, the school smoked, no matter what age you were, whether you were a freshman. When I got there, I was a sophomore, and so immediately, like, the first friends that I had, they all smoked, and so that's just what I started doing. And I smoked off and on until October 17th of last year. Obviously I didn't smoke while I was pregnant with my son. And when I was, like, I think a junior and a senior, I was sent to some family friends in Florida, and I would never smoke in front of them. Like, I would never do it. And so I quit for like a couple summers, and I tried quitting a couple, many times after that. But I would say solid, I smoked for 10 years, which is terrifying. But the reason why I wanted to do this video is because it is exactly 6 months today that I have been a non-smoker, and that is a huge achievement for me. So that's it. So I would say solid, it's been over 10 years that I was a smoker. How much did you smoke? I was a freaking chain smoker. Anything that set me off, I would smoke. Anything that was great, I smoked. You know, talking on the phone, I smoked. Drinking a cup of coffee, I smoked. Getting mad, I smoked. I smoked heavily. I was a chain smoker, you guys. It was bad. It was really bad. I wouldn't say it was exactly a pack a day, but it was, you know, kind of shy of it. A pack would last me like a day and a half. So, did your parents smoke? My parents both smoked in the 80s. My mom, you know, in the 80s, a lot of women, like, smoked through their pregnancies. Like, I know a ton of, like, my friends' moms and, like, family members' moms smoked through their pregnancy. You could smoke in the hospital. You could smoke, you know what I mean? Like, they didn't know certain things like they do now. And I feel like cigarettes weren't as bad. But my mom, it made her so sick. And so she quit with my brother, and she never picked back up again. So I never saw my mom smoke. My dad, however, quit when I was really, really young. Like, I don't remember him as a smoker, you know what I mean? So it definitely wasn't like something that was in my household. Like, nobody smoked in our vehicles, nobody smoked in our house. Like, I was not exposed to smokers in that way. I have one older brother, and he started smoking obviously before I did, but you know, when I was in Vegas, I feel like I was a little bit more straight and narrow, and I like kind of scolded him a lot for it, but what are you gonna do? What reason made you finally quit smoking? So on October 17th, 2016, my husband, myself, and our son set out on a brand new journey, moving from DC here to Arizona. We had a career change, we had a life change, and last year was really, really hard on me personally with just personal things, you know? I made a video about last year. I did have a miscarriage in May, and so I just had a really shitty year last year, honestly. And when we hopped in the car on October 17th, I was like, this is it. This is going to be a new challenge. It's going to be a new journey, and I want to start it off correctly. You know, I just didn't want my son to identify me as a smoker. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't want him to grow up with it. I didn't want it to be on his clothes. I didn't want it. That was just something personally to me. You know what I mean? I just did not want that to be something he identified me as. Like, my mom is a smoker. That was just something personally that I didn't want to live with, you know what I mean? And just the whole new life start, you know what I mean? And not to mention the fact, like, we drove out here. And my husband is not a smoker. I don't know if you guys know this about my husband, but he is like the most clean person I've ever met in my life. Like, he's never put anything foreign in his body like that. Like, he's never succumbed to peer pressure of like smoking a cigarette or smoking pot in high school, or, you know what I mean, underage drinking or anything like that. Like, he is just clean. He's never even had a speeding ticket, you guys. Like, my husband is like clean, you know what I mean? And that's what I needed in my life, and he completely balances me out. And so it really wasn't fair to him either, like, coming out here on a 4-day road trip, like, you being stuck in the car, like, you want to smoke every time you stop, and you want to stop more often than you really need to. And then you get, you know, we have a 2-door Honda Civic, so every time I would get back in the car, like, he could smell it, the baby could smell it, and you know what I mean? Like, I would get pissy and mean until I could smoke, and then I was fine. But then, you know what I mean, Andrew's obviously, like, not happy because I'm smoking, so then I get mad again, and that makes me want to smoke again. It's like a vicious, ugly, disgusting cycle. And so I just, you know what I mean, it was my breaking point where I was like, I don't want to do this. As soon as we came home from the hospital with my son, I was smoke free. You know, I didn't find out I was pregnant, I think, until I was like 2 months pregnant. So for 7-8 months straight, I didn't smoke. And the first thing I wanted to do when I got home from the hospital, that baby was out of me, I wanted to smoke. And that's what I did. You know what I mean? And I'm sure it wasn't the smartest decision. You know what I mean? Because I did breastfeed, and, well, I pumped, but anyways, you know, it wasn't the best decision for me or for my son. And it was so selfish, but I did it. I really did. So, you know what I mean? It was so stupid to have that under my belt of being smoke-free for 10 months, but it wasn't my choice. You know what I mean? Like, I did it for Aiden, and it wasn't for me. And that was in my mind. That was the thought process behind it. So, anyways, that's what made me want to quit smoking, was a brand new journey. Did you use smoke-free aid like Nicorette gum or patches? No. So this time, I didn't do anything. I did cold turkey, and it was literally the hardest thing I've ever done, especially being in a car and being, you know what I mean, like, I like completely stopped doing everything that reminded me of smoking. And I've heard stories going either way, like of avoiding things that remind you of smoking or to keep doing things that remind you of smoking so you can learn to do them without the cigarettes. But for me personally, like I stopped drinking coffee and I was fine. You know what I mean? Like I don't talk on the phone as much anymore, which is kind of shitty towards like my friend aspect, but I'm slowly like reintroducing it and I'm doing it without cigarettes and I'm fine. I think out of anything that worked for me as far as like a smoking aid goes, the patches worked the best for me because it completely took away that feeling. It is the most like horrible, terrifying feeling. Like I tried to explain it to Andrew so many times just because he's never been addicted to anything and he's never had like a foreign substance in his body to like change his moods or anything. Like explaining to him the way withdrawals feel is like wanting to get outside of your body. You know what I mean? Like you're scratching your way from the inside out. Like that's what it feels like to me. But the patches completely like diminished that. So it completely took that away and its system is pretty ingenious in the way that you start off with like one patch that has so many milligrams and then you slowly like wean off of it if you wanted to go that route. For me, the e-cigarette was replacing one thing for another. I did try the blue. I never used a vape machine or anything like machine, you know, guys know what I mean. I never used anything like that. I tried the blue cigarette, which it still has like a little bit of nicotine in it. I tried the gum and it was the most disgusting, awful thing I've ever put in my mouth. I did not use any aids for the very last time. Did you gain weight? Hell mother fluffin' yes, I gained weight, which is so weird because like I felt like I cut out things. I swear to goodness, when I was a smoker, the most calories I had during the day, it wasn't even food, it was from drinks. Because when I was a smoker, I had to have something to drink when I smoked. Like I couldn't just go outside and smoke a cigarette. I had to have like a cup of coffee, I had to have a soda, I had to have flavor. It couldn't be water. It had to be something with flavor in it. And literally I would take a drag and then drink a sip. Like it's the weirdest like regimen, but that's, I had to have something to drink. And so I was drinking like 5 cups of coffee a day. I was drinking maybe a soda a day or 2 even. I was drinking juice. I was drinking anything with flavor because I smoked so heavily. Like I had to have something, you know what I mean, while I drank. And so it just, I swore that I would cut out so many calories by not being a smoker, but I gained more weight. Like right now I'm down a little bit, but the first couple months I was here, I was the heaviest I've ever been in my entire life. Ever in my entire life. Even more so than like, I was almost as heavy when I had a baby in me, which doesn't really count. I feel like that weight gain doesn't really count. You know what I mean? Because you have a baby inside of you. But those first couple months I was here is the biggest I've ever been in my life. So I gained a ton of weight. What is life like as a non-smoker? It is magical. Number one, being, and Mary mentioned this in her video as well, is that in the morning I can take the biggest deep breath and just go and I don't cough, I don't lose my breath, you know what I mean? When I was a smoker, and because I smoke so heavily, I couldn't even barely like take, not even a deep breath, but like almost couldn't breathe in the morning. If I went in too far, I would just start coughing. Like, and that ugly, like raspy, deep smoker's cough. That's the first thing. The second thing is being able to smell my shampoo. Like that's a huge deal for me. I don't know why, but like being able to smell my shampoo or my perfume throughout the entire day. That was one thing about me as a smoker, is I was absolutely, completely and utterly ashamed of it. Like I wasn't one of those smokers who was like, I'm a smoker and that's what it is, you know what I mean? And was comfortable smoking in front of anyone. Like I wouldn't smoke in front of anyone like from Andrew's work or on base or anything like that. Like even when I was at my house, because it's like a community backyard, I would kind of hide myself a little bit just in case like somebody Andrew or I knew came by and like saw me smoking. If they drove by, like I would absolutely die. I would. And so even people that I worked with, like I didn't want them to know. And so I had this like routine. So I had a smoking bag, legit, and it was like a makeup bag, and I had hand sanitizer, lotion, lip gloss, gum, and perfume in there. And so I would smoke, you know what I mean? And then I would sanitize my hands, I would put lotion on, I would put a piece of gum in my mouth, put on lip gloss, and then spray myself with perfume. And so nobody ever knew I was a smoker because I hid it so well, because I was so absolutely ashamed of it. I just knew it wasn't something, you know what I mean, that I wanted people to judge me on, like, oh, she's a smoker. Like, that was my biggest fear, is like people would find out and be like, ew, she's a smoker. You know what I mean? Because it's not accepted now. People do shame you for smoking, which I would never do. Now that I'm a non-smoker, like, I wouldn't be like, oh, she's a smoker or he's a smoker. You know what I mean? And when I smell it now, like, some, it depends on like which way it hits me. Sometimes I'll be like, oh, that's the most disgusting smell ever. And sometimes I'll like inhale and be like, oh man, that smells good. You know what I mean? And I just, you know, I do want to mention that just because I'm doing this video and I have been a non-smoker for 6 months now, doesn't mean I would shame anybody or judge anybody because they are a smoker. I don't feel like it changes you as a person. And I used to get so upset when people would find out and they'd be like, you don't look like a smoker. Like, you know, I don't know. I just don't want you guys to think that now that I'm not a smoker. And if any of you guys are out there smokers, and then, you know what I mean, like, I don't know about it, or if nobody knows about it, like, I'm not judging you. And I don't want you to think that I'm saying you shouldn't be, you know what I mean? Because when I was a smoker, like, I loved smoking. I did. Even though I was ashamed of it and I didn't want anybody to know I was a smoker, I never wanted to give it up. Like, I wasn't gonna quit, you know what I mean? And I would tell my husband that, and I would tell my mom that, like, I'm gonna quit when I'm ready. And that is the case, because when we came out here, I was ready. You know what I mean? It was just that time. And so I'm getting off the subject of the question, back to life as a non-smoker. Another amazing thing about being a non-smoker is I save a ton of money, because I was buying a pack almost every single day. And back in DC, they were like close to $7. You know what I mean? That was like, I don't know, $30 or $40 a week. I put that towards makeup now. That's like my trade-off and like my reward to myself for not being a smoker. Like, I buy so much more makeup now than I ever did in Maryland, in DC, because it's like kind of the trade-off. Like, sure, I should be putting it in a savings account, but it just keeps me going almost. Not keeps me going, but I feel like it's a nice reward to myself for, you know what I mean, choosing to be a non-smoker and everything like that, so. Just, let's just say that. How hard is it to stay quit? For me personally, now it's not hard at all. Because I think about smoking every single day. You know what I mean? It's not like that. But I never have gone to the point where if I'm like inside a gas station or inside, you know what I mean, like Walgreens or where I used to buy cigarettes, I've never like stood at the counter and like looked at him and been like, oh man, you know what I mean? Like tempted or anything like that. It's not hard for me at all, because again, I just think about my son, you know what I mean? Like, that is so inspirational to me. And, you know, another thing I didn't want, I forgot to mention in, like, life as a smoker is that Andrew and I are much closer now. You know what I mean? Like, not getting into details, but, like, we're much more intimate. Just, like, everyday, like, intimacy. Like, giving each other kisses and, you know what I mean? Like, talking to each other. Like, when I would, like, even though I would do all these things, you know, of, like, the gum and everything like that, I would still like talk to him and he could smell it on my breath and he would do this little cough and it used to piss me off so bad, but he would go, you know what I mean? Just to let me know that like my breath smelled or my hair smelled or he could still smell it on my hands or, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. And for him to not do that anymore and we can like be right up in each other's faces and, you know what I mean? It's just amazing. Like, that is such a good trade-off as well. It really is. What is your proudest moment as a non-smoker? I don't really know how to answer that. My proudest moment is just today. I, like, you know what I mean, have been doing stuff all day, and I knew that I was gonna film this and get this up today because it's exactly 6 months, and, like, that, for me, is huge because I'm not using anything to be a non-smoker, like any gadgets. And I'm not saying that it's a bad thing, but just for me, like that is amazing to do cold turkey, which is the hardest, but from everyone I've ever talked to, doing cold turkey is what makes it stick because you're not substituting one thing from another, you know what I mean? And 6 months, like by choice, like my choice, like not because of anything else that's going on or, you know what I mean? Like I wanted to be a non-smoker. Like I'm really proud of myself to say that, you know, as kind of cheesy and arrogant as that sounds, like I am proud of myself. I'm very proud of myself. And I don't get to say that very often because I am kind of hard on myself, but this is something that I'm probably one of the proudest things besides my son that I've ever done. What words of advice would you give to others who still smoke? Do it for you. Don't ever try and quit for, you know what I mean, your husband or, you know what I mean, something like that, because it's not gonna work. I tried when Andrew and I very first got married, I told him that I was no longer smoked, and I think it was about maybe 6 months in, we went over to a friend's house and we were drinking and she had cigarettes, and it just took one, and I was completely sucked back in. Like I was ready to start that, you know what I mean, life with Andrew of being, you know, he was inspirational because he was clean and he, you know what I mean, didn't do anything that was harmful to his body. Like that was super inspirational. He doesn't drink, doesn't smoke, doesn't do any of that. And so I was a heavy drinker and I was a heavy smoker before Andrew and I got together, and it was so inspirational and I wanted to give that to him, but I wasn't ready myself, if that makes sense. So it's like kind of like a two-parter. Like number one, do it for yourself. Number two, once you do it, you cannot, if you're like me and you were a heavy smoker, you cannot pick up one because it'll never just be one. I know tons of people that can pick up one and they can be fine, but for me, I could never just pick up one or just isolate it to like when I had a couple of drinks or anything like that. Like it could never be isolated for me. If I picked up one, it was back on like Donkey Kong. You know what I'm saying? As stupid as that sounds, but it's true. I can't pick up one, and I know that. And that's exactly what my mom told me as well. She's like, I knew if I picked up one, I wouldn't be able to do it. And same with my grandmother, who was a heavy smoker as well. And this was like back in the, you know, 60s and 50s and 60s, where it was like okay to smoke anywhere you wanted, you know what I mean, and on airplanes and doctor's offices, no matter where. And she said she was 40 years old, so it was 1961, so that was when my mom was born. And she said that she had trouble breathing and she knew it was smoking, and she knew if she just picked up one, she knew she would start all over again. And that's in a time where it was socially acceptable and encouraged, you know, they were everywhere. Everyone offered them to you. It was a social thing to do. It's, I think, almost easier now that people, not that I agree with the shaming, but I feel like it's easier now because nobody is like forcing you or encouraging you, you know what I mean, like society. I'm sure that there are people in your lives, like all of my friends, you know what I mean, almost when I was in Vegas, almost every single one of my friends smoked, and so it was a social thing. But now I don't know one smoker. I don't know like in my vicinity that like is around me where I'm like tempted or anything like that. So that is something that is in my favor. But you know what I mean, that may be something that's gonna be harder for those of you who maybe has a spouse or a sibling or a friend who is a smoker, like to be around it. But my best advice to you is definitely cold turkey. And when you're ready, you're gonna know when you're ready. And you're gonna be strong enough to do it, because I, like I said, had been a smoker for over 10 years off and on, but it was time for me and I was ready. And so now you know another dirty little secret about me. And that is the no smoking tag, or how I quit smoking tag. I know I was all over the place, but again, this was something that I have buried deep down and I was so ashamed of it. I really was. I wasn't proud of it, but it was something that I enjoyed doing, and so I knew I was going to keep doing it until I was ready. And October 17th, 2016, I was ready, and I haven't looked back since, and I have no plans on picking it up again, because I know if I pick up one, it's done. So I hope this was helpful to some of you. If it was, give it a thumbs up. If you maybe have your own story of how you quit smoking, and anybody else that wants to do the tag, I highly encourage it, because it's just another thing that you can look back on and be like, I remember I was like a year, I was 6 months, I was whatever, you know what I mean? I said sober and Andrew started laughing, but to me that's what it feels like, because it was such a hard addiction to break. So that's it. I'm done rambling. I know this video is so long, but I love you guys. Please subscribe if you're not already, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye!